war against oppressor. And I'm going to talk to you from the book of Ecclesiastes. Ecclesiastes 4 verse 1. Ecclesiastes 4 verse 1. Thank you, Jesus. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Father. Yes, Lord. I worship you, Lord. I thank you. I give you all the glory, Jesus. You are wonderful. Wonderful God, I thank you. I bless your name. I give you the glory. Yes, Lord, you are wonderful. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. You are wonderful. You are an awesome God. Yes, Jesus, I love you, Jesus. I worship you. I give you all the glory, Jesus. Christ is 1 verse 4. The Bible says, again, I observe all the oppression that takes place under the sun. I saw the tears of the oppressed with no one to comfort them. The oppressor have great power and their victims are helpless. You see, the oppressor have power, but the victims, they are helpless. Nobody help them. Nobody comfort them. The oppressor, they are so powerful. Oh, yes, 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 yes. I need to charge my computer. That's what the Bible says. The Bible says, the oppressors have great power and their victims are helpless. The oppressor have great power and the victims are helpless. But God is your helper. The Bible says, trust in me, and then I will do great things that you do not know. Pray, ask me anything in my name, I will do it. Yes, oppressor, they have big power. They have a lot of power. They can do you anything. But remember the children of Israel. They were in the bondage. They were slaves in Egypt, 400. But when God raised them up, when God delivered them, and the enemies were following them, the enemies died, all of them. So you are oppressors, as the book of Ezekiel, as the book of Isaiah said, he will die. Oppressor have been oppressing people. They have been terrorizing people. You don't know what to do. But God, who is God, he will fight for you. Have your peace and trust him and be faithful with him. He will show up. He will never fail you or forsake you. Only stand still, you will see salvation. Yes, his oppressor can be very powerful, can oppress you everywhere, anything you do, because they have a position and they have authority to do that. But when Almighty God will revenge them, no one will help. They will waste them and finish them. Therefore, I am praying to you, any power that is oppressing you shall die in Jesus' name. Let's continue looking at the book of Ecclesiastes 7 verse 7. The Bible says, extortion turn wise people into foolish, and the pride corrupt the heart. You know, people are very corrupt. That is corrupt the heart. The Bible says, Ecclesiastes 7 verse 7. The Bible says, oppression makes a wise man mad. And here, that is King James. King James, he said, oppression make a wise man mad. You can be very, very wise. You can be very smart. But if you are under the oppressor, you will run mad. The oppression can make you mad. Many people who are intelligent, very wise, very clever, excellence, the oppressor can turn them to foolish. They can turn them to mad. because they sit on them. They have power. They control them. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Lord, I thank you. My God, my Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray that your eyes can be opened and see to oppressing in the name of Jesus Christ. Yes, Lord, I thank you, Father. Lord, I bless your name. I give you all the glory, Jesus. Yes, Ecclesiastes 7 verse 7. That's what the Bible says. In King James here, it says, it makes oppression makes a wise man mad. But here in the NIV, it says, this is what NIV says. So I don't know which is which. Extortion turns a wise people unto foolish, and pride corrupts the heart. So oppression makes a wise man mad because they have power. They can oppress you, they can bring you down, but Jehovah God will help you. I pray that anything planted in you, in your body, to cause you sudden death, I shake you off in Jesus' name. I want you to pray this prayer. I will talk slowly so that you can catch what I'm saying. Say, anything planted in my body to cause me sudden death, I shake you off in Jesus' name. Therefore, anything planted in your body to cause you sudden death. You know, if you are so oppressed, it can cause death. Because oppression, they can press you, you can't even breathe. They cause you sickness. The oppressor wants to destroy you. That's why they press you. This is the people, this is the power of the people. Your boss, your husband, people who are under you, that they want to see that you are finished, you are pressed down. In the book of Isaiah 6 verse 1, the Bible says, in the year King Hosea died, I saw the Lord seated on the throne. Thank you. Yes. Yes, my son. Thank you so much. Thank you, Deborah. Thank you, Sida. I see you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. I didn't know, my son, you could catch me the way I talked. Yeah, hallelujah. I don't have my glasses, so I'm struggling. I'm straining to see, but I'm trying to see. That's why I'm so close to the computer like this and my Bible like this. Wow. I'm trying to use my eyes, not my glasses, but I'm straining it. So, I thank God because your Hosea will die tonight. This evening, Hosea is going to die. Your Hosea must die in the name of Jesus. The Bible says, in the year that King Hosea died, I saw the Lord seated on a throne, high and exalted, and the trains of his robe filled the temple. Today, we shall be looking at a serious topic that has sent so many people to the earth grave. This topic has sent so many people early grave. They have made many people to die. They have sent many people to early grave. They have made many people to die because of this enemy called oppressor. Hallelujah. I was talking to the morning. If you have not replayed the prayer, the video of in the morning, go. This is part two of it. Go and review it and see the words that I was using. So, many have lost confidence in themselves. We have also been looking at a topic that made many to lose hope and became slaves to their enemies and the sermon, and it is titled. You see, people have lost hope. You can talk to somebody. Yes. Thank you, my friend. People who have lost hope, who do not have hope, they are so wounded. You can just talk with somebody because this person has been oppressed so much. Then when you just talk with the person will hear that you are cursing him. It does, they don't hear, they don't listen properly because of the oppressor. It is, they have been oppressed, now they want to leave to somebody else. Now when you just, even you can say somebody, I met a lady, she was standing on the road. And then I say, hi, I was passing by, I do walk. I usually walk sometimes in the morning when the weather is good, I do walk. So I found this lady, she was waiting for the bus. And I said, hi, hello. The woman looked at me very bad with the very, she want to attack me. Then I just keep on walking. Then she click herself, because I said hi. Just I said hi, she click herself, said, she was mad because I said hi. Now, if I could say, I could talk or I could say something, she could have ended, she could have pick up a fight or started quarreling or started cursing, but I just continue walking the way I was walking. So some people that are so wounded because of this oppressor. When the oppress them so much, the Bible says, you see, they feel like they lose hope, they have no alternative. God, and when you look at the Psalms 91, verse 5 and 6, the Bible says, the Bible talks about the terror of the night. What the terror of the night? What this means is that there are powers that people that operate at night. There are some powers that people operate at night. In the dark and the in the dark, that is when they know how to operate. That's why we have prayer. Yes, Psalms 91, verse 5 and 6. That's why we do the prayer of midnight. Because that is the dark time from midnight, 12 midnight to 5 o'clock. That's the time of big trafficking of huge. What the enemy is doing. They can do you anything between those hours. That's why we do them. And if you miss midnight, 5 o'clock, you must do something. What they have done the whole night, 5 o'clock, you destroy them. If you miss midnight, 5 o'clock, you have to do something about them. So that's why we have to pray. We need to do a lot of prayer. We need to pray very hard because the enemy has changed their gear. The enemy has changed their direction. Now they are attacking people from different angles. But the Bible tells us we are not ignorant for their schemes. Hallelujah. Thank you so much. Thank you. So, the Bible says about the terror of the night. What this means is that there are powers and the people that operate at night. In the dark hours, they have mission of oppressing you. In that dark hours, they can oppress you. They can call your name in a coven. They can chant and speak wickedly. They can speak everything about you at night, chanting, saying, when you wake up, let the sun come down against you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Yes, dark hours. Yes, dark hours, they can chant and speak and send charms mentioning your name. Now, they would say, when you wake up in the morning, let the sun strike you, let the sun smite you. That's why we pray the sun shall not smite. When you look at Psalms 121, that the David was praying about the sun shall not smite you or the moon during the noonday or the night. So now, the powers of the night, because you can see what the Bible is talking. There is some people who operate at night. And when you are sleeping, their work is to chant against your family, against your man, against your work, against your career. They will say, all the money that you are getting, let it be dry up. Let it be wasted. Then you find you squander your money. You don't know how to use the money. You get money, good money.